Hello fellow blenders, today, or tonight, whenever you're watching this, I am going to be showing you guys how to make this scene right here. It's a very simple tutorial. All you need to know how to do is use two modifiers, three actually, basic modeling skills and Bezier curves, but that's about it. Anything that you don't know, I'll go over in detail and how and why it works. So let's get started. So the first thing that you need to do, if you haven't already, is make a new project. Next thing you want to do is hit A, then X to select everything, and then delete all the default objects. Next thing you want to do is click Shift A. It'll bring up this add menu. You want to go to Mesh and add a plane. This will be the basic room for your scene. I'm going to go ahead and scale this up by 1.5 to make it a bit bigger. Next thing I'm going to do is go into edit mode by hitting Tab. Or you can go up here to select object mode and then drop down to edit mode, but it's easier to switch with tab. So now that you are in edit mode, you are going to change the selection type from vertex to edge. So let me explain this real quick. Vertexes are essentially corners in a 3D world space. Edges are the edges that make up the object, and faces are the in-between mesh, I would say, between the vertexes and edges. The way I would best describe this is like a, what are they called? A kite. So the edge of the kite, well, the edges of the kite are just the metal or wood cross pieces that make up the kite's frame. The vertexes are where the kite's frames meet, and that's where they're held together. And the face is the fabric of the kite. So now that we have that explained, we are going to go into the edge select mode and select 1, 2, 3 edges, and we're going to extrude them up. Now when you hit extrude, it does this wavy thing and you really can't control the direction, you have to just eyeball it. To fix this, you want to hit Z on your keyboard, or Z, and then drag your mouse upward. This will lock the extrusion along the Z axis, which is the upward axis in 3D world space. That can be seen right here. So the x-axis goes horizontally left and right when you first start the scene, y-axis goes forward to backwards, and z-axis goes up. And you can click on these different things, so you can go into orthographic view, which basically has no perspective, and that's so you can get more fine detailed objects. Now then, so the next thing that you want to work on, the next thing that we're going to start to do is the couch. So, and another important thing that we're going to do really quick is when you're making a scene or an item in Blender, or in any modeling software for that, or even if you're making a game, you want to have a good naming convention, or you just want to name your objects. So to name an object in Blender, right click here, go over to the hierarchy, double click the name, and I'm going to name this room. Good. So now I am going to go back into edit. This next part is just for finer detail. I'm going to go into edit mode. I'm going to go into face select, actually no, I'm going to go into edge select, right click on this edge, shift S, cursor to selected, or you can do shift S2, and then I am going to tab out of edit mode so the 3D cursor stays there. If you make an object in Blender, that object will appear where the 3D cursor is. For example, shift A, mesh, cube. The center or the origin point of the object appears at the 3D cursor. Now I'm going to drag this cube forward and SZ to scale it down along the Z axis. I'm going to bring it up a bit so it's a bit above the floor, scale it a bit down on the Y axis, so that's front to back. You can do that by hitting SY, and I'm going to bring it back a bit on the Y axis, that is G, then the Y key. You can also do the same for G, X, and Z. And I'm also going to scale it out just a tad bit and scale it down just a bit more. This will make up the frame of the couch. And so I don't get confused at which object is what, and so I can see it a bit better, I'm going to go into the hierarchy, click this I button to hide the room. Great, now I just have the couch. So with the couch, I am going to now make the armrests in the back. To do that, I'm going to go into edit mode, and I'm going to do Control R, and I'm going to bring my mouse up to about there, scroll up once, left click, then hit Enter. And that just adds an edge loop, so that makes more edges and divides the object up a bit. So I'm going to hit Control Z until those are both selected again, and I'm going to hit S, X, and drag them out until they're about right there. So that will make up the sides of the couch, but I'm going to do this in one fell swoop. I'm going to also make the back at the same time. I'm going to do Control R, left click, and drag it. You can also drag edge loops over to about there. I'm going to go into my face select mode. Here, 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 and here. You can select things by right clicking. I'm going to drag them up to about there. And then I am going to continue with the back of the couch until about there. And don't worry about fine detailing yet. This is just the basic information of the couch. I feel like these armrests in the back is a bit too high, so I'm going to click Tab and scale this entire object down just to about there. That looks good. Now, to add a bit of detail to the couch, we're going to bevel it, which is essentially turning these edges into smaller edges, like that. But it's a bit weird. So the first thing that we're going to bevel is this part of the couch. We're going to right-click and select these edges. I'm pretty sure there's an easier way. Yeah, if you hold left-alt and right-click, that'll select the edge line. Then you're going to do Control-B, drag out just a bit. To add more bevels, actually no. And we're just gonna drag out just a bit and click here. Now that doesn't look like it beveled too much, so it's just at a small angle. To fix that, we're gonna right click and by holding Alt right there and select all those edges, hit G, Z, and drag it down a bit. So that will have it beveled a bit more, and we're gonna do the same for these right here. Control V. Drag it out just a little bit. Select here and here. Drag that down to about right there. Don't worry about those triangles. Those will not show up in object mode. And we're also going to do this edge here and here. Drag that down. And we're going to do the same thing here. We're going to drop that down a bit. Ah, this created an issue. That made a little corner piece right there. And a little trick in modeling, or even beginner modeling, if it does something like that, you can also just Control Z it until it fixes itself. But that's not what we're gonna do. You face select, hit X, and then go down to faces. We'll do that for both sides. Next, I am going to go into vertex select here and here, and then hit F to make an edge there. And to fix this, we're going to go into edge mode. Select all of that to make a triangle and hit F again, and then hit F again. This creates faces, so it basically creates the fabric of the kite between the beams that it has. I'm not sure what to call them, so I'm just going to call them beams. Do the same thing for the other side. Select them both, hit F. Oh, I messed up. There we go. And now when you go into edit mode, the problem is fixed. It just goes right down into it. Now then, so this couch is a bit bumpy, so the best way to fix that is to right-click on it, go down to this wrench icon, which is the modifiers, click that, add modifier, generate subdivision surface. That will make the object smoother and a bit, not crispier, just a bit more organic, I guess you could call it. That's what I'm going to call it. And yeah, now you're good. And now that doesn't look too good because that kind of slowly drops down right there, and that's not what we want. We don't want a valley. We want crisp-ish edges. So we're going to hit A, click W, and hit subdivide once, twice. But this created another issue. This has created lines right there. To solve that, we're going to hit Control Z until it goes back before the subdivisions. We're going to get rid of the subdivision modifier, and in the beveling process of the couch, we've created N-gons, and N-gons are faces with more than four vertexes, vertices, and that will break games, and it also will mess up the subdivision process. So we're going to fix that by selecting vertices, hitting F, selecting edges, hitting F, until we can get shapes with four or less sides. You cannot, faces with four or less sides. You can not have a two-sided face though, because that is just a two-sided thing though, because that is just a line. There's also another issue here that we're gonna fix as well. That triangle, delete that, and delete that, and we're gonna do the same thing that we did right there, and we're gonna divide it into two smaller triangles. So just selecting those and pressing F is how you solve that. And we're gonna do that, then that, and that. Good, now when we add the subdivision modifier onto it, that looks much better. When we subdivided it, that created another problem with the three lines. And that's because we have this giant piece right here is another n-gon. So we wanna delete that face, take these two vertices, and close them. Then 1, 2, 3, 4, that's a face. 1, 2, 3, 4, that's another face. Now then, when we subdivide and subdivide a bit more, good, it's fixed. Except for there, what's wrong there? More n-gons. So I'm just gonna go around the object, I'm gonna cut to when all the n-gons are fixed. All right, now I have solved the n-gon problem. I also turned on smooth shading, so if you don't like that blocky look, click W and shade smooth. And it still has the valley thing, but that can be fixed by going into edit mode, control R, clicking here, backing that up, and then again by doing control R and dropping that down. Great, now you have the couch look messed up a bit there. Control R, drag that down to about there, that's fine. Good, so now the couch actually looks like a couch-ish. Now we can start making the cushions. So to do that, we're going to go into edit mode, use the same tool that we did before by making the cursor, the 3D world cursor where we want it, by going to edit mode and then changing like that. So we're going to do Shift A, going into cube, scaling it down to about there, scaling it out, GY, oh, that's locked. So if that ever happens where you do GY and it moves in increments like that, that's because you turned on snapping, and just click it to turn it off, and now you can move it like that. Good. So now you can do that, scale that back a bit. It doesn't matter if it clips through as long as it shows it back. Well, it doesn't actually matter if it shows through the back because it's not going to be showing. So, oh crap. And now we go over there, move that out a bit. Scale it out a bit more. I'm also going to scale it down a bit. And here comes another problem. We can't get a very exact look, or can't actually get too exact on this cushion being in the center. So how I'm going to fix that is I'm going to click Tab. I'm going to have my face select on. I'm going to select this face. I'm going to hit N. You have to have global turned on. The median for X should be 0. So now that is exactly aligned with this green line right there. Great. And I'm also going to bring that back just to about there. Good. So now that we have the first cushion done, I am going to hit Control B and scale that down to about there. I'm going to scroll up to add smoothness, I guess, to it, so you can actually have that cushion look. What I'm also going to do is I'm going to click this edge select tool. I'm going to hold Alt and click here, and then hold Shift and click there. So I can do that, scroll out a little bit, because we don't need that much geometry. Just make sure that when you're beveling, here, these two lines right here and here, they shouldn't touch, because that will just create issues. Great, now that you have that cushion done, we're going to make the location of it 0, so it's in the exact center. We are then going to go into the modifier section, add modifier, and generate mirror. Now, when we go into edit mode, hit A, and move it over. It'll be exactly the same distance apart without any work. Good. I'm also going to bring this couch scale a little in like that, and move that over just a tiny bit so they're just barely touching. Good, that looks good. And we were done with the bottom cushions. Now, you also want to make this smooth shading. Now we want to make the feet of the couch. To do that, this cube right there and that cube right there is already fine, but we just need to do another one. Control R, click, drag out to about there, and now you can make your feet. To do that, we're going to select all of these. We're going to hit I, and drag that in a bit. I is individualizing them, so it kind of extrudes each one of them at a time inwards. We're going to hit E, Z, and drag them down to about right there. And that's what's going to make the bottom. So those don't look good because they're rounded, so we're going to do Control R, left click, drag all the way down for each of them. Okay, that looks good. Now we can turn the room back on to just center out the couch a bit. Couches are usually up against the wall pretty far. Nope, we've got the cushions. So to select multiple meshes, click one, hold shift, hit the other, Control Y, GY, and drag that to about there. Good. Now, in the original photo, there was a popcorn bowl with popcorn in it. So that means we have to make a bowl. So left click to move the cursor, and I'm going to put it right there. I'm going to do Shift A. I'm going to make a UV sphere. That's going to be huge, so we're going to have to scale that down just a bit. And we're going to bring that up, bring that over, scale it down just a little more. And we're also going to rotate it to right there. Good. So now, I'm going to go to edit mode, edge selected, moving a bit closer, and we're going to select right along this we're going to select right along this middle line by holding Alt and right clicking. Then we're going to hit W, and then mark seam. So that will mark the exact center of the sphere. So now we're going to click an upper face right on. We're going to click an upper face right here. Then we're going to hover over and then press L. That will select everything up to this seam right there. So now that we have the bowl, I'm actually going to do one more. One more. To do that, you just have to click this line right there. You're going to hit X and then faces. Now we have a nice little bowl shape. But if you were to put this in a game, or even in real life, bowls have a little rim, I guess, to them that goes inwards a bit. But in a 3D world space, that has no depth. To give that depth, we're going to go into Modifiers, and we're going to press Solidify. We're just going to drag that in a little bit until you get the bowl shape. Now when we hit Apply, that actually gives that a little lip. So now there is room that makes it actually look like a bowl. I don't think we could subdivide it. We actually can subdivide it. Yes, we're going to subdivide it to make it a bit smoother, shade it to smooth. Now that's looking like a really nice bowl. And we're going to start moving this around the scene, scale it up a little if you need to, bring it up, and just move it out a bit. So it looks like, let's move that forward, that way, up, so it's just resting on the edges of the couch. So that way, it'll look like it's just sitting there and being held down by gravity. So now we just need to make the popcorn. To do that, we are going to go into edit mode on the bowl. We're going to apply that subdivision modifier shift. We're going to go into the edit mode, into the bowl. We're going to click here, hit Alt, never mind. We're going to click here on this edge, and we're going to hit Alt, right click. That will select the entire rim of the bowl. Next, we're going to do Shift S, cursor to selected, which will put the cursor right in the middle of the bowl. We're then going to do Shift A, and then make a plane. We're also going to rotate that along the Y axis to about right, we can drag that down, angle it about right there. Now then, to add the detailing on this. Alright, so the best way to do this, to make it look bumpy and make it look like that popcorn feel like I showed you in the photo, is to go to Modifiers, Subdivision Surface, 1, 2, and then we're going to hit Apply. That will give a lot of faces, and it'll also smooth it out so we can scale that down a bit. so it matches the bolt. And a little bit more there. Move it in along the y-axis. You can also scale it out. And out again. Good, so it's also not coming out. Actually, it is a bit right there. Also, I'm just probably going to move that back so it comes out of the back of the bolt a little bit, so that you're not going to be seeing that. So the next thing that you want to do is, once you have it subdivided, since we don't have enough vertices here, A, W, subdivide, subdivide, subdivide. So that is a lot of subdivisions. So in one face, you should have 4,096 faces. That's a good amount for it. I'm going to go back into object mode, modifier, and then we're going to go to displace. And that will bring it up, but we don't want that. We need to get going to textures, new texture, image or movie, but we're going to make it clouds. So that will now make it really, really bumpy. So to fix that, we're going to go back into it, back into the modifiers, and we can turn the strength down. So now that that's falling out a bit, we're going to apply that modifier, subdivide it, and then we're going to smooth shade it. So now that looks, well, doesn't right now, but it will look like popcorn once we texture it. And from a distance, it looks even more like popcorn. Next, we're going to make the table. So we want the table to be right around where the mouse is. I'm going to go click on the room, tab, go into face select mode, click here, shift S, cursor to selected, go back out, and make a cube. Scale that down a bunch on the y-axis, in, back, up, and then scale that inwards on the z-axis and just bring it to about right, what's a good table height? Right about there. Up a little bit more. Now to make the table legs. We're going to go under the table. We're also going to get rid of the room so we don't feel crowded. Under the table, we are going to do hit Control R, bring up to about there, scroll up to 2, scale out along the y-axis to about there, Control R, left click, Control R, scroll up 1, double left click, S, X, to about there, and you're going to select each of these faces, hit I, scale them in, E, to extrude, scale them down. This is where we need the room back, because we need to get the legs on the floor, so let's go about right there. And actually, you know what, we're going to scale them up a bit, make this look fancy. We're going to scale them down to there. We're also going to scale them in. But see how they do that? We want them to scale individually. So to do that, you go up to this little drop-down, go to Individual Origins. That will allow us to scale the origins of them individually, so we can do them all at one time without having to look at a bunch of numbers. I would just add a subdivision modifier, hit Tab, A, subdivide that in the context, was that called? Yeah, context menu once, and then set it to smooth shading. Also going to go into edit mode and make some edge loops around the legs. And to make that little side table that was right there with the remote on it, we can just right click on the table, shift D, left click, and we can just move it over. Then we can SX, scale that in to about there, and boom. We've got a side table. Make that a bit wider and a bit shorter. Okay, now that he has the side table, we can start making the remote. To do that, we're going to go into edit mode, select that vertice, shift S, cursor to selected, tab out, make a cube, scale that down a bunch. Oh yeah, to do this fly around camera thing, you want to do shift and then the tilde key at the top of your keyboard should be right next to or under your escape key. Good, so now that we have the cube made, We're going to SX, scale it in, scale it down, bring it up a bit so it's just resting on the table, and then we're going to bring it to about there, scale that in. So now most remotes look like that. So we're going to scale it forward, scale it out, scale that a bit, bring it forward, bring it forward again, scale it in, and then we're good. So now that we have the remote, we're going to subdivide that. Subdivide it in the context menu twice, and we can start making the buttons. The buttons are going to be super easy. What we're going to do is we're actually going to subdivide that one more time in the context menu, but we can get rid of the subdivision surface modifier. Okay, so now that we have a bunch of that, we're going to start making the buttons. The way I'm going to do this, I'm going to click here, here, and I'm just going to select every other thing, I guess. Every other face. And it's a bit tedious, but trust me, it will look great once it's done. How do I want to do that? Usually they have a number thing at the top, so I'm going to do this. Alright, now that they have that, I'm going to do one large-ish button right to there, and that will be the power button for the TV. So we're going to do E, scale it up. Oh, forgot to turn off individual origins, but that's, yeah, so we're going to go to medium point again. Okay, so now that we have that, those buttons set up, we can just scale them up to our desired height, which is about right there, and we're going to bevel them inwards and scroll up twice. Good, and so that looks like a remote now. So now that you have the remote done, now the last thing to do is to make the TV and then texture everything. So we're going to go over the table, do the median point thing, make a cube, scale that down, make sure it's resting on the table, scale it out a bit more, and then what we're going to do is we're going to bevel that to about there. And then to make the screen of the TV, I'm going to scale that inwards by using the I key, drag that inwards till about right there. And that's not really going to be shown, I just use it for light reflecting and displaying purposes, and I'm also going to bevel that all for the same reason. Find the median point of that, shift A, cube, scale that down, that's going to make the back of the TV, cable area of it. We're going to only bevel this face, we're going to bevel it a lot. We're going to do the same for edges. We're going to Alt-click here, Shift-Alt, Control-B, and scale that in, and smooth that, and that looks smooth. Good. Next thing that we're going to want to do is to make the wire. The wire is super easy, but easy to get confused on. And once you do it, you'll never forget. So select an area about right there. I'm actually going to choose that one instead. Shift-A. Instead of going into mesh, we're going to go into curve. The curve that we want to choose is Bezier. And that will make a line that doesn't have any geometry whatsoever. And it's just going to plop it into 3D world space. So we're going to scale it down a bunch, because we don't actually need that much of it. And we're just going to drag it out. Drag it to about right there. Rotate it along the y-axis. R, Y, negative 90. Move that over, GX. Move that over. Move it inwards, move it down, so it's intersecting with that. R. And I might rotate it a bit along the Y-axis. You can actually see it curving. And I like the look of that. Move it just over a bit more till about right there. next thing I wanted to do is go to this curve part right there. Yeah, you can. So you're going to go into extrude to add a little bit, bevel it just a tad. Just fine tune that a bit. And now you have the cable, maybe even scale the cable down just a bit and bring that curve thing by going into edit mode back to the TV. Good. Now you have your curve. I might just bring this curve down a bit more, bring that over there, the entire part back. Okay, so now the frame of the camera will be right there. This next part is the fun part, in my opinion. This is where we make textures. So to make textures, or to make materials, I should say, it's super easy and very fun. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go up to this little gap right there between the outliner, this toolbar, and the 3D view. I'm going to click until I get that crosshair, left click and hold, and drag it out to right there. I'm going to click this drop down and go into Shader Editor. Okay, so now the first object that we want to do is the room. The room, we can just make a new material and call it walls. Once you make that material, it'll pop up in this material tab in the walls details. And to do that, we can just, I'm going to go into Render Eevee, which is the render engine that Blender 2.8 uses, just so I can get a basic color. I'm going to do a nice light blue. It's going to take a bit of fine tuning, but I like that. So next thing that you want to do is the floor. So you want to go to edit mode. Over here, you're going to click this plus. You're going to hit new, and you're going to hit assign, all in that order, otherwise it won't work. Now this material 01001 will pop up. We're going to name it floor. I'm actually going to name it wood. No, I'll say it floor. And I'm going to make it a dark brown. Good. Now we have to focus on lighting. In the example photo, I only used one source of lighting, which was the front of the TV. So we're going to select the front of the TV, plus button, and hit assign, and hit new, and we're going to delete the principal BSDF node, and we're going to make emission. We're going to type emission in, and we get this emission, and that will act as the light source for the TV, but it doesn't actually light up the room. That's because we are still in Eevee render engine. So I want to go over to this camera icon right here, or it's render. We're going to click the render engine drop down and change it to cycles. And that will make it look a lot better. So the TV is a bit dark, so we're going to increase the strength to about 10. And make the color slightly, turn down 0. Make the color a little blue. I'm going to drag it in a bit towards white a little more so it's just a tad blue. And that actually looks like a TV now. And this is the end result. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you guys want another tutorial or if you want me to explain something in more detail, leave a comment down below on what you want to know. Have a nice day.